We are going to do some running drills. So I've been wanting to do this, and I wanted to put it together. So I know everybody's wanting to run. It's going to be nice, like hopefully next week again for a little while. And so I wanted to put together this workout to kind of give you some ideas of things that will help you get stronger when you're running, help you with your endurance, help you with your balance. So we've been talking, and I did this before. I want to go ahead and do it again, and I'm going to go through it with you, and hopefully it'll only take about 30 minutes. But today I'm going to kind of work on more of the strength and mobility, the balance, and then the next time I do a workout, I'll go ahead and put in some of the drills, like skipping and hopping and those kinds of things that you can do when you're actually out on your run. So I'm just going to go over some things today with you that kind of explain what you can do before you run and what you can do after you run, and then drills that you can do to kind of work on your strength days or your balance, your mobility days. You can work some of these other exercises in. So I've been putting this off. I was thinking about doing it last week, and it's just been crazy. And if you can tell, the color of my house is different, and we have new curtains. So we've been working. It's been a long day. And I wanted to get this in before I went to bed. So I wanted to go ahead and show you some of the things we're going to do. So I'm going to turn on music just so we have background, so it's kind of quiet. All right. So when you're going out on a run or a walk or a jog, whether you're doing a 5K or a 15.1 or 26.2, I've done all three of those. And the 26.2 one time. But I've done a lot of 5Ks, I've put on 5Ks. I know there's gonna be some soon, hopefully this fall or late summer. And so there's a lot of different things you can work on for drills for this. So today you're just gonna need a mat. And if you have a tennis ball or a BOSU ball, or not a BOSU ball, a medicine ball, this is a soft one. So one that you can kind of grip onto. We're going to use this. This one's 4 pounds. You can do 3 pounds, 4 pounds, 5 pounds. Or if you just have a tennis ball, that's okay too. Okay? So, before you run, you don't want to just take off running. One of the things that I've read is that you want to do some different things to kind of warm up. You can walk first, you can walk and jog. But before you even do that, they suggest you doing a lunge matrix. So, what you're going to do for that, just going to get ready. You're going to go forward, side, and back. And then the other side. Forward, side, and back. And they want you to do this for about 3 to 4 minutes. Keep alternating. All right? So it's forward, lean to that side, put your weight on that leg. And then when you go back, your back side is here. Okay? So keep your shoulders back. To the side, push your seat back, and then shoulders back again. So it's forward, side, and you can do this with me. Reverse, forward, side, reverse. Good. So you just want to keep doing this. It's kind of warming up your muscles. Notice you're going all different directions, so it's kind of getting those ankles warmed up, getting your leg muscles warmed up. Working on the balance a little bit. All right. I've been wanting to get out this week, and I hate running on the treadmill. I'll do it if I have to. But it's been really windy, or rainy, or cold. I think it's supposed to snow tomorrow, but I'm hoping not. But we live out in the country, and we don't have a lot of things to block the wind. So, my dog is mad at me right now because she wants to go, but I heard it's going to be 60s next week. So here are some drills, like I said, and we've been doing this about a minute and a half. We're going to go to about 2 minutes, and then I'm going to show you some other stuff. So a couple of these things are balance. A couple of them are just flexibility. We do work on our stretches. You might want to make sure you do stretches at the end of your run. You can do a warm-up and then do some stretches, but the best time and do your stretches at the end of your workout, because your muscles need to stretch out for two main reasons. First reason is you don't want to be sore the next day. So if you stretch, that's going to help prevent some of that soreness the next day. The other thing is your muscles are nice and warm at the end of your workout. So if you stretch, that's when you're going to gain more flexibility. Because at the end of your workout, once your muscles are all warm. Okay? All right, where are we at? Almost there. I think we're going to go. Whoops, I switched legs. We'll switch. Here we go. Forward. Side. Oh, we got some body here now. All right. Last set. Forward. Side. Back. Last one. Forward. Side. Back. And that is actually 3 minutes. Okay? So you want to take a little bit of time. I know we always try to like, okay, how much time do I have to run? You want to make sure that you're warming up. They say that that's one of the best ones you can do. So once you do that, your muscles are warm, heart rate's up a little bit, take off and run, okay? And we can talk more about that next time on how do you work on getting to where you can run more. I know there's a 5K, Couch to 5K. That's an app that you can follow. That's one of them. We do telephone pull to telephone pull out here. So that works too. Now, after your run, like I said, you always want to stretch. We're going to save those stretches for the end because we're going to do some strength exercises and a little bit of mobility to end stretching. So, the next thing we're going to work is we're just going to work on our balance. So, I want you to go ahead and lift one leg. Even if your toes are just touching, I just want you to hold it. And we're going to go for 30 seconds. Okay? Now, if you start to lose your balance, you can use your arms. Get your balance back. Leg is slightly bent. Don't walk out your knees. Because again, when we do that, we arch our back. It hurts our lower back. You want to keep your seat tucked under a little bit. Now, if you're going to make it a challenge, let's close our eyes for 10 seconds. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, so if you had your eyes open, you saw it. Let's walk my balance. So it's something that's good to work on. Let's try the other side. We've got it. We're going to do the same thing. Make sure your knee's slightly bent. Don't lock it out. And we'll get to the last 10 seconds. We are going to try to close our eyes again. Okay? All right. Here we go. Close your eyes. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. You're just watching this without the sound. You're going to think I'm crazy. So that's a good one. And you can do that 30 seconds up to 60 seconds. 30 seconds is pretty tricky. Now, the next thing you can do is get a step or a BOSU. Try not to close your eyes on the BOSU, but the BOSU is like a half ball. If you guys haven't seen this, I know if you've done my class, you know what a BOSU is. But a half ball that you balance on, or if you have one of those balance boards that's kind of wobbly, that really works on your balance. Try that for 30 seconds. Other side, same thing, 30 seconds, okay? Or just coming up on your tiptoes. Try to balance on your tiptoes. Hold it there. All right. 4, 3, 2, 1. Now, that was about 15 seconds. Try the other side. So you're going to come up on your tiptoes. And you're going to notice your balance is better on one side than the other. Hold it there. You got it. It's tricky. 5, 4, 3, 2. All right. So even just going up on your tiptoes, okay? But a lot of these things that we're doing today are 1 foot, because if you have to go on 1 foot, which we're going to balance a little more, you have to use your core a little more, and your ankle strength is really important, okay? So that's another reason that you go on 1 foot. Next, you're going to pick up your ball, and we are going to do single leg, ball, toss, and catch. Okay, you can do this with a partner, or if you're by yourself, you're just going to go from one hand to the other. One side, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Good. Now, to the hard one. I skipped the easy one. First one is actually 1 foot, but you're just gonna go up and down with both hands, okay? So you can do this one with a partner, just tossing it up and down 10 times. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, okay? And then you're gonna switch to the other leg. Ready? Knee slightly bent. 1, 2, 3, keep your eye on the ball. 4, funny story about that. 5, 6, 7, I once hit my nose doing this. 8, 9, 10. Okay, so if you've ever done CrossFit, you do the ball and you throw it up against the wall balls. Well, we were doing it against the tree. And I had just started doing this with my husband. And he's like, just throw it up and hit it right up there on the tree. So I threw it up there and it went through my hands. And this was like a 10-pound ball. Bonk, right on your chin or right on my nose. So always make sure that you're paying attention when you're throwing the ball. And we're doing it with 1 foot. So again, you can do it with a small medicine ball or you can do it with a tennis ball. But, you know, this is not too bad. 1 foot, you want to make sure you're looking where you're going. Okay? So you want to do the single leg ball, toss and catch about 10 on each side. Then, the next thing we're going to do, you're going to put the ball down, is we're going to reach, we're going to work on a squat and reach. 1 foot again. So you're going to hold one leg up, or just back, you know, keeping your weight on the one leg. Your toes can touch if you need to, but we're working on reach side, reach forward, reach the other side. Okay? So down, up. Down, up, down, up. Same thing. Side, middle, side. That's 3, 4, 4, 4, up. Again. Five. It's been a long day. Middle, side, good. That's 6, side, 7. No, that's 6 still. Now we're on 7. Down, middle, reach to the other side. 3 more. 8. Middle. Over. Now you should be noticing this leg is tired. 9. Middle. And side. Last one. Side. Center. Side. Okay, so that makes your leg tired. Shake it out, roll your ankle. It should be aching a little bit, and that's what we're going for. We're working the ankle strength, okay? Other side. Side. Center. Other side. That was a tricky one. Again. Side. Center. Side. That's 2, 3. Whoop. Middle. Side. That's 4, side, middle, side. So you're doing a little squat with this leg. Side, middle, side. That's 6, 7, middle, reach. That's 8, side, middle, side. You still with me? Is that 9? 1. 2, seconds on each arm, on each leg. Now, the next one we're gonna do, you're just gonna hold the ball. You're gonna do reverse lunges, holding the ball out here. Okay? So it's one leg and the other. One leg and the other. Got it? All right. Keep going. Make sure you hold that ball out in front. And make sure you're sitting back. Feet tucked under. Take off. There's other kinds of things where you can do explosives. So like we'll go over that in the next one. And then of course sprints, which are everybody's favorite. We do those out here. Sprint one telephone pole, recover to the next. Sprint the next telephone pole, recover to the next. So you just, you know, those are really good for you. They actually help you. Even running slower when you're recovering, it helps your speed, helps your endurance. So the next thing is we're just gonna go on to 14 different kinds of strength exercises for running, okay? And a lot of these we do in classes, a lot of these we've done before. I just wanna go over them, and we're gonna do 10 to 20 of each thing. And so, first one, of course, squats. So if you're wanting to make sure that you're gonna have good form, so when you do it, you wanna sit back, squeeze your glutes. Two, up, three, squeeze your glutes. Four, squeeze, five, up, six, squeeze, seven, squeeze, eight, squeeze, nine, squeeze your glutes, 10, squeeze, 11, squeeze, sit back, squeeze, 13, 14, keep going, 15, squeeze, 16, four more, two more. Make those count. You're just doing squats, not really paying attention. You want to come down, squeeze your glutes. Think about what you're doing, okay? The next one is speed skate. So just step, tap, tap, tap. We're going to do 20. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, jump squats. Now, if you're training to walk or jog and jumping up and down is really hard on your knees, same thing, tiptoe, knee bend. Tiptoe, knee bend. Otherwise, 20 squat jumps, ready? Here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, issues, I'll be careful. I have a little bit of a knee issue, so I'm going to show you holding on to something. And that's what a lot of people do when they first try it anyway. It's called a pistol squat. So, what you're going to do, I'm going to hold on to my grandfather clock and hope I don't fall. You're going to put one leg out in front, and get down and up. Down and up. That's two. My leg's really tired. So, you're going to have to work into those. I'm going to try to show you my other leg. This is my horse knee, so hold on to my other chair. Down, and I'm not going down as far. That's okay. And up. So that's a pistol squat. You keep one leg out in front and up. And I'm on my rocking chair, so I don't know. It's a little wobbly. And take it all the way back up. Okay, so that's another one. You don't have to do that one, but it's a good one. Okay? Just be careful with your knees. And they say do 10 and 10 of those. So forward lunges, forward. And it's a little bit better, helps you with your balance more if you lift your leg up. You don't have to, but take it up. That's four. Five. Stay on that leg. Six. Seven. Keep your shoulders back. Eight. Nine. And ten. Okay? It's making you work that leg a little more because you're having to hold and use that leg the most. We're going to try the other leg. One. Two. Hold. Three. Up. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Hold. Nine. Ten. Okay? Four lunges. Pretty easy. Next, heel raises. Again, one foot, like we did. One, down. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Now, if you need to hold on to something, that's okay. Nine, ten. Other leg. One, two, you'll find one's easier than the other. Three, four, this is my weaker one. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Okay, now, one leg hops. We're going to do it in the way I was showing you. You're going to take it up. One, two, three, four, five, six. Seven, eight. We're going to do 15 of these. Nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. You got it. 15. All right. Other side. One, back. Two, three, four, five, six. Seven, eight, almost there. Nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Stop. Okay, so a little bit of explosives like we were talking about. Working on one leg. Okay. Now, we're going to go back down to the floor. Until the very end, we may switch that a little. Now I think we'll do that, and then we'll be up. All right, so side planks, 30 to 60 seconds each. We'll just do 30 seconds. Same thing. Now, if you're just starting, you can keep your knee on the floor, okay? If not, one little challenge. We're gonna have 30 seconds on this side. Now, you can always add. So, if you want to hold one leg up, you can do that. If you want to add crunches, we did those today, didn't we? All right. Or you can just hold it. We got 10 seconds. So we're going to start with 30 today, and then we have two regular plank. So, you know, there's tons of different things you can do. 30 to 60 seconds again. But you can hold it, okay? Or you can do leg lifts. All right, we'll keep counting, but we're gonna try different things. You can do taps out to the sides. If you need to start on your knees, that's okay. Or if you wanna hold it here, do knees down and up. That's another choice, okay? Now, we can swivel hips, one of my favorites. You can go up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down. Or you can just hold, or we did forward, back, did we? Forward and back, that's another one. Or you can reach, reach, reach. So all kinds of planks, okay? We easily did 30 seconds there. So back, stretch. So 30 to 60 seconds of a plank. You don't have to just hold it. You can do different things that kind of breaks it up and makes it go quicker. Okay, so do the plank hold. We are going to do the last one on the floor and then two of them standing, and then we will do some stretches, okay? All right, so this next one, you know, stay here. You're gonna take your one leg up and down. Up, three, four. Now, you can also do straight legs. Six, seven, eight. There's tons of variations on this one too. 10, 11, 12, keep your toes facing forward, 13, 14, 15, take it in, okay? You can do more of those. I like those, actually. You can do less, you can do different kinds. All right, so, you can start in the bent knee, keep your top legs like parallel to your bottom one. Three, squeeze. Four, this is a lot of resistance on your part. Okay, if you have a circle band, you can put these between around your knees or your ankles. Same thing, you can do them with straight legs. What number are we on? 10, 11, 12, keep your toes facing forward. 13, 14, 15. Good hip strength there, okay? Outer thighs. Okay, so we're gonna go back up. Scoot my mat back. Now, this next one is a side shuffle. Even though when you're running, you're going forward, hopefully. Get to work on your side sides. Okay, so we did like side, we did the skater. This one is side shuffle. We're gonna go one, two, three. Now I don't have enough room, but you're gonna go 10 each way. One, two, three, again. One, two, three. Now to make this harder, circle band around your ankles. Four, your legs. Three, one, two, three. Last one, one, two, three. Okay? So side shuffles. We don't have a lot of space to do those in here, but outside, you can even kind of do those on your run sometimes. If you're running and get tired, or you just want to do some different things, if you're not, don't get embarrassed easily. You can be running and all of a sudden you can do your drills, okay? Or just start running sideways like that. So, it's up to you. I would do it. Then the last one is burpee with a push-up. Oh yes, we saved this for the end, okay? So we're gonna try to do 15. Now you can do 15 to 20. You can do more, you can do less, but we're gonna shoot for 15 today. So actual push-up with your burpee, okay? So it's gonna go down, out, push-up, and up. Down, out, push-up, and up. That's two. Down, out, push-up. That's three. Down, out, push-up. That's four. Down, out, push-up, five, push-up, six, down, out, push-up. Seven. We're halfway. Down. Out. Eight. Maybe I should have said 10. There's 9. 10. 11. Now you can always do the knees. 12. 13. 14. Last one. And stop. Whew. Did you hang with me on those? Those are not easy. I don't usually do the push-up part. Okay, so this has given you 40 minutes worth at least of exercises that you can do before you run as strength training, mobility, balance. We're going to do our stretching, so our flexibility. So after your run, okay, some of the best stretches. You want to stretch out the legs, of course. So this side of you here, press that back heel down, get a good calf stretch. You bend your back knee, shins, Achilles tendon in your heel. Okay, straighten it back out. Bring that leg in, push your seat back. Toes up so you can feel that stretch all the way up the back of your leg. All right, slowly come up. Let's do the other side. Hold that lunge. Bend your back knee. You get shin splints, this is a good one to do. Another one is to take your foot, go up against the wall, and put your, the front of your foot up against the wall and lean into it with your heel on the ground. That's good for shin splints too. I used to have them a lot. Now I have plantar fasciitis. Yeah, you're gonna bring that back again. Can you help with that? Let me know. I can know all kinds of things for that. How to take your foot, how to ice it, stretches, a boot you can wear to bed. That's really fun. I wear inserts every day. That's pretty much how I take care of it. All right. Now, another stretch is grab one foot. You can hold on to something. And you're gonna press your knee down towards the floor, so that you get a really good stretch in your quad and your hip flexor. If you want to get a little bit more stretch or you're not feeling it, you get really flexible, you can lean forward, okay? Now that same leg, you're gonna bring around. Again, you can hold on to something, but this is really good for your hip and your glute. And you're gonna do that stretch too, okay? All right, let's do the other leg. Grab that foot, or shoe, or sock, or ankle, whatever you can reach, and hold that stretch. Now, some people, if they've had knee issues, you can put your foot like on a chair or a ball and hold it there. If you're having trouble with balance or it really hurts to have it up that close, you want to hold it up there, but not quite so close, okay? All right, so again, you can lean forward, get a little bit deeper stretch, and you're going to bring that leg around in front and sit back. Okay, good stretch, hip flexor and glute. Hip flexor, hips and glutes. What time is it? Almost 1 a.m. It's gonna work out sometimes. I have my Wi-Fi. Okay, so now we're gonna stretch to one side. Because when you run, you use your obliques a lot. You use your core a lot. So you wanna stretch it out, okay? And your lower back a lot. So, we're gonna go ahead and bend down, and then round it up, lower back stretch. Good, take a deep breath in. Breathe out. Clean the one side again. Good, and come up, breathe in. Other side. And come up. Now, this one, you're gonna pull forward, tucked under. Round your shoulders. So you're getting a really good stretch right here. Knees bent. Come up, breathe in. And breathe out. hands behind. All right, so one more stretch, hamstrings again, and chest and shoulders. So I'm gonna turn sideways, okay? When you're here, keep your eyes open. See how far forward your arms can go to stretch, okay? Now bend your elbows, bring down, bend your knees, slowly roll it up. All right? Okay, you're ready to go. All right, so that was about 45 minutes total with a stretch. You don't have to do all those exercises on the day that you run, but you can do those on your off days. So if you run Monday, Wednesday, Friday, Tuesday, and Thursday, add these exercises in, okay? If you have any more questions about anything, please let me know. Like I said, I've done lots of 5Ks and half marathons, one full. I have training schedules that I use when I do my workout to train for things. And so just let me know if you guys are wanting to do something like that. So usually you want to take at least 12 weeks if you're going to do a half marathon and you've never done one before, at least. If you're doing a full marathon, I trained for about 4 or 5 months. It's usually 4 to 6 months at least when you want to train for that. If you're not used to doing all the miles, then there's a big long training for it. So if you have any questions about any of that, let me know and we will put you together a workout. I've helped several different people train for half marathons and no one wanted to train with a full. No one wants to do a 20-mile long run. So, but if you do, let me know and I will help you out with that. So hopefully this has been helpful to you. And like I said, if you have any other questions or anything, just let me know. All right? You guys have a great night, and I will talk to you soon, probably in a couple hours.